Your next comedian, ladies and gentlemen, he was a semi-finalist on America's Got Talent, and he also appeared on MTV's Wild and Out. Welcome to the stage, Jacob Williams, ladies and gentlemen. Jacob Williams.
Thank you. I just so you guys know, I don't know how to fix your computer. I just look like I do. Just wanna... I like doing comedy. One time I did a show and someone introduced me. He was just like, give it up for Jacob, he's single. And then I realized I'd never told him that I was single. So that was kind of awkward. There's an older lady hitting on me after that show, but she was a lot older than me. Like, not like a cougar, but like a saber-toothed tiger. I do like doing comedy. I'll be doing some comedy later in my set tonight, but I've had some other jobs. I did real estate for a while. I just wanted something more stable, so I started doing stand-up comedy, and I had to do a lot of cold calls at that job, which is not a great way to meet women, I found out. I don't know if there's anything I could have said, like, hey, what are you doing after this phone call? Do you want to go out sometime? I already have your number. Hello? All right. I had this one job where I got a lot of lectures, and my boss would say things like, you know, it seems like you only come into work when you feel like it. I was like, actually, that's not true, because I never feel like coming into work. So technically, I come in slightly more times than that. But the last time I talked to him, he's like, you got to make some changes. I'm like, what's he going to do, fire me? Which it turns out, yeah, that's exactly what he did. And my goal at that job was to work the least amount where I wouldn't get fired, which I don't know what that amount is, but now I know what the amount right below that is. So that's good to know. I got fired from an unpaid internship one time. I didn't know that that could happen. They were really nice about it. It's like they were saying, like, you're fine, but we're gonna go with uninhabited space instead. We just feel like you're less productive than this empty void over here. I've been trying other things like acting, and I've mostly gotten cast as a background extra. People saw my acting, they're like, we think this works best if you don't say anything. And if you could stand really far away, that would be great. But I was an extra in a play in high school in Greece, which usually they don't have extras in plays, but at first I was excited. I was like, oh, I got the part of Alan in Greece, which if you saw the movie or the play Greece, you might not remember the character Alan, because he wasn't in it. It's just a name they made up. They're like, yeah, you're the greaser that doesn't say anything. He just does the hand jive in the background. My friend, she came and watched the play. She was in the audience, but she had the same amount of lines as I did, so that was cool. I got a letter through certified mail recently, and I went to the post office with the certified mail slip, and I was like, hey, I'd like to pick up the letter that goes with this. They're like, well, we have to see a piece of mail with your current address on it. I was like, actually, the certified mail slip technically is a piece of mail that has my current address on it. That's why I have it, you know? Like, actually, I think you guys were the ones that sent it to me, you know? And, it's not like I like snuck into someone's house like, oh man, I really want to steal an errand. And I thought about it. I was like, actually, there is another piece of mail with my current address on it, but it's in the back of your post office. That's kind of why I'm here. So if you could go and get that and bring it out here, that would actually solve both of our problems. And they didn't like that idea, so I had to leave. But anyway, after that, I got stuck in traffic, and this one guy threw a slushie on my car, out of his car. I don't know if that's happened to anyone. Like, maybe he does that a lot. Like, he has a bunch of slushies ready to go. He's like, oh, that guy didn't use his turn signal? Here's a blueberry one. Rah. Or like, I don't know if he was having a bad day. He's like, oh, I lost my job at the place where I got all these neck and face tattoos. But he threw it, and then he pulled in front of me. I don't know what to do in fight or flight situations. I usually have the flight instinct, but the problem is I don't know how to fly, so I have to figure something else out. And I just yelled after him. I was like, oh yeah, well, I was gonna wash my car anyway. Now you don't have a tasty dessert drink to have later, so I feel like I won that one, but I'm not sure if he heard me because my windows were up, but I, anyway. I was driving one time not too long ago. It was snowy out, and it was in the winter. There was a lot of snow and salt on my license plate, and I got pulled over. And the cop was like, hey, did you know I can't read your license plate? I was like, no, I did not know that. I probably wouldn't have pulled over. I knew that. That would have been great to know a couple minutes ago, but I... And then he's like, I have to give you a citation, which at first I was excited. I didn't know that's the same thing as a speeding ticket. So I'm like, that's fine if you want to give me a citation. Like, I thought you were going to give me a ticket, but yeah, if you just want to use me in your essay, then that's just okay with me. You can verify my new address. I've got two letters right here. So anyway, that's it for me. Thanks so much.